What would you think if someone told you that most of the ferret food you see on display at pet stores is actually harmful to ferrets? Well, in this video, I'll show you why you should avoid commercial ferret foods and what is actually biologically appropriate for your ferret to eat. Ferrets actually share the same nutritional needs as cats. However, commercial ferret food is significantly worse than cat foods in many ways. Because cats are a much more popular pet, the pet food industry is much more obligated to cater towards those nutritional needs. Ferrets, however, are viewed more as a cage-bound pocket pet that falls into the same category as rats and rabbits, which results in cheaper-made foods for convenience sake. Here's one of the main brands you will see in a pet store and what employees tend to urge you to buy when purchasing a ferret from them. The very first ingredient is chicken byproduct. While it is an animal protein, it doesn't mean it's nutritionally beneficial. Animal byproducts are what's left of a slaughtered animal after the parts intended for human consumption have been removed. This can be parts from dead-on-arrival animals or other condemned parts that have been declared inedible and unfit for human consumption, but is still used for making pet food. Next is cornmeal, which is used as a filler and has no nutritional benefit whatsoever for ferrets. The rest of the ingredients are completely synthetic vitamins, which are chemical products created in a lab that have different biological structures than vitamins which occur naturally in fresh whole foods. So, what should you feed your ferret? The best way to figure this out is to look at what their close ancestors eat in the wild. One of their closest ancestors, the polecat, eats rabbit, rats, mice, small mammals, amphibians, and birds. So, how can you simulate this? The best way to do this is, of course, to feed whole prey. However, this can be expensive and a bit trickier to source. So the second best thing is to create a frankenprey diet. Frankenprey is a technique that attempts to approximate whole prey by creating a balanced meal out of muscle meats, bone, and organs spread out over the course of a week. If you're getting a baby ferret, it's extremely beneficial to transition them to raw right away. Ferrets imprint on the food that they have been fed over a long period of time and don't recognize other types of food as food. So after about 8 months, it only gets more difficult to transition them to raw, but of course it can still be done. The cuts that comprise a frankenprey diet are raw meaty bones, muscle meat, heart, liver, and a second secreting organ. Raw meaty bones are chewable bones with meat surrounding it from animals such as chicken, quail, rabbit, duck, frog, or Cornish game hen. Muscle meat is comprised of any boneless meat that has not been smoked, pickled, cured, or seasoned. This can range from chicken, duck, pork, goat, beef, turkey, lamb, and even wild game. Gizzards are also considered muscle meat, not organ. While heart is a muscle, it's actually in its own separate category because heart is necessary in the diet to meet adequate taurine requirements, as lack of taurine can lead to neurological diseases and eyesight problems. Lastly, the organ meat. At least half of the total organ content needs to be liver, while the other secreting organ can be kidney, thymus, pancreas, spleen, or brain. So, how do you actually feed all of this? When transitioning a kit, especially if they're very young, it may be as simple as just placing these cuts in front of them and seeing if they will actually eat it, which they might. If you have success, you can start prepping out your ferret's meals for the next week or so. You do want to start out with one protein and slowly add in more to make sure your ferret isn't sensitive to something in particular, i.e. like a chicken allergy. So for the first few days, you may want to feed just chicken neck, gizzard, heart, and liver, and then add a second protein and so on. Kits should be offered food at least 4 times a day and should be allowed to eat as much as they want, which is usually around 20% of their body weight. Ferrets don't often overeat and are great self-regulators, so you shouldn't have a problem with, you know, a ferret overeating or becoming obese. The base percentages ferrets should be fed is 75% to 80% muscle meat, where 15% of that is heart, 10 to 15% raw meaty bone, 5% liver, and 5% other secreting organ. Some ferrets do better with more bone, some less. This is just a base and should be altered accordingly to your ferret. Now, on to prepping. So I'm prepping for my adult ferret, but the only difference between my prep and a prep for a kit is that you would just need to add a bit more to each meal and spread it out between four meals versus two, which is what I'm doing. My adult ferret eats about 4 ounces a day. And for a kit, it may be up to 10 ounces a day. This is the average weekly meal plan raw feeders usually use for ferrets. It's essentially balancing over time or spreading their nutritional requirements across the span of a week. While this is the most popular way to feed, there is also another way, which is essentially portioning their daily meals with each of these cuts, but in smaller portions, so each day they have a balanced meal. And I say balanced loosely because we don't really know all that much yet about what is actually nutritionally balanced for them as far as Frankenprey and Prey Model Raw goes. This is why, again, I tend to feed whole prey as much as I can, or at least incorporate it a few days a week. Some other beneficial additions you can add to your ferret's raw diet throughout the week is low mercury oily fish, such as smelt, sardines, anchovies, mackerel, things like that, and also egg yolks. Egg yolks can even help with hairballs during shedding season. So, I hope this video was a good introduction for you to begin feeding your ferrets a raw diet. I do urge you to continue your research because there is a lot to learn. At the end of the day, we're all just trying our best to feed our animals the closest to what their bodies were made to consume. If you have a cat or a dog and are considering feeding them a raw diet as well, check out these videos to learn more.